Hello, welcome ladies and gentlemen back to another edition of Business World. I'm Yusuf Gamereddin and it's great to have you back. Today's talking point will be facilities management, and it may seem like an ambiguous term to many, but we'll discuss all the definitions related to the term and how it impacts a given economy and how it can help your business as well. I'm joined by two special guests and I'll introduce you to them right after this. Hello, welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. You tuned into Business World. I'd like to introduce you to our two guests on the show today, Mr. Stan Mitchell, the founding chairman of the Global Facilities Management Association. Thank you very much for being with us. And of course, Mr. Alan Penrith, the UK Director of Trade and Investment. Thank you as well. I'd like to start with an overview of facilities management, which is defined differently, even within experts in the field itself. How would you define facilities management briefly and perhaps very simply?
Facilities management's core business is every other organization's non-core business.
Okay.
So our business is to manage the support services and activities that enable the core business, a TV studio, a hospital, yes, a factory, to fulfill its core activities.
Okay, so you'd consider this a type of outsourcing in a way?
In some instances it's outsourcing, but in some instances it can be delivered by an in-house team.
Okay.
The principle of what you do and how you should do it is the same.
All right, then could you perhaps give us an example of a facilities management activity, perhaps to begin with, or different types of facilities management?
Well, facilities management fundamentally is a management activity. So it's the management of all of those diverse core support service mm-hmm. activities,
yes,
in a holistic way that supports the core intent of the organization.
Okay.
So traditionally, they would all be doing their own thing. Security would be doing its thing, maintenance would be doing it, landscaping would be doing it. Facilities management is all about understanding what the core business needs are, yeah, and making sure you deliver that to a certain standard.
Okay. Now, Mr. Penrith, what would you say is the reason that the UK government is interested in facilities management, and why do you think it's attractive not only to the government but to businesses in general?
Well, I think it's attractive to both government and business for a number of reasons. Firstly, I think it's a very efficient way of delivering public money from the government perspective. So in the UK, we've used facilities management as a key component of our PPP, public-private sector partnership approach,
okay,
to business development. So we're talking about schools, hospitals, prisons, wherever the government is putting money into new ventures under the PPP heading. The government wants to see a very good, efficient return on its investment. And the approach that Stan has just outlined is now a key component of PPP projects. So it's built into the design of the project. The government already is saying it wants this sort of service as part of the overall project itself.
Mm-hmm.
Now this is happening in the UK. PPP is happening in Egypt. So I see real potential for growth in Egypt on the government side, but also in the private sector, because the fundamentals operate on both sides of the fence. People want to lower their costs, they want a more efficient return on their investment.
Okay. But facilities management is a relatively new field of study, a new field of science, maybe? I don't know. How would you put it? I mean, give us an overview historically. I mean, this is less than three decades old.
Yes, it's probably the newest professional discipline within the built environment, because most of the focus is around the built environment, although facilities management is also all about how an organisation functions within a facility.
Okay.
But the driver, in actual fact, if you look back in those three decades, one of the key drivers, as well as government initiatives and government recognition that the operational dimension of any project represents 80% of the whole life cost.
Yes.
But the other driver in the last 30 years has been recession. And worldwide, we're currently in the middle of one of those. Mm-hmm. And the reason for that is that the facilities management remit, if you like, is the overhead cost to that organisation.
Yes.
And that is typically the second highest cost to that organisation, behind perhaps salaries.
Yeah.
So the logic of managing that professionally to certain standards that are appropriate for the organisation actually makes a valid contribution to the bottom line if you're talking about commercial organisations. Mm-hmm. And if you're talking about governmental type agency or organisations, then it also makes a valid contribution to the cost, that in return on investment that Alan's just mentioned.
Yeah.
In terms of the efficiency of government.
Yeah.
So of any organisation.
Okay.
Can I just add to that in terms of the government's perspective? Because there's another aspect of what's going on in the UK economy at the moment, and that's the drive towards a low carbon economy. And this again is of interest in the UK, it's of interest to Egypt, it's of global interest. So organisations are driving these days to reduce their carbon footprint. They're trying to reduce the energy they're using.
Indeed.
You asked for an example before of how this might work in a practical sense. A company like Stans might come in and take a look at how a company is using its energy, or a government department's using its energy,
mm-hmm.
How it's actually operating and using its resources. With the sort of advice that they can bring, and in a real practical way, we're using Stan's expertise to come in and look at the British Embassy, for example.
Okay.
Look at our carbon footprint, look at how we're using our energy, and give us some advice on how we can reduce our use of carbon, but also introduce efficiencies. You know, at the end of the day, it saves the taxpayer money.
Yeah. Well, we'll take a quick break from our discussion, but don't go anywhere, because we'll take a look at a special report, and we'll be back right after this.